Today's video is greatly inspired by Psych2Go's video detailing 7 signs you have a fear of intimacy. We understood it very well and thought some of those are pretty obvious, so we decided to make our own version.
For today's video, we'll tell you the 5 surprising signs you have a fear of intimacy. Because let's face it, some signs aren't that obvious.
And since we want you to know how to attract men and avoid having fear of intimacy, we'll also tell you the one way you can learn to be more intimate and open. So let's not wait any longer. Let's get started. Number 5, always on the go.
The first signs you have a fear of intimacy is that you're always occupied and on the go. You might be wondering what being busy has to do with being afraid of intimacy.
If you're always occupied with things and always busy, it means that you avoid having more time with people.
You might not know it, but one of the things men want women to do more is to slow down and spend more time with them to get on a more personal level.
So if you want to know how to get your crush to like you, you should slow down and be more open. Having fear of intimacy will make one avoid human interaction as much as possible because you know deep inside that the more interaction you have with other people, the more likely it is that you'll have to say something deeper about yourself and actually be intimate. If the thought of that scares you, you definitely have a fear of intimacy. Being intimate, amongst others, are things that men wish we did more. Learn more about that with this video from us. Number 4, too many faces. Be completely honest with me here. Do you have a solid idea of your real self? Do you know how to be your real self?
If your answer is no, well, that's one of the signs you have a fear of intimacy. If you're more used to hiding parts of yourself from other people to be what they want you to be, that's a sure sign.
Have you ever thought about how to make him want you and then thought maybe you should mold yourself to be his ideal girl? Have you ever changed the way you appear to other people in order to satisfy their ideal person? People may think that they know the real you, but you know to yourself that everyone knows a different side of you. And no one knows the real you. Maybe not even you.
The only real thing about having too many faces is that you're lonely. You feel like nobody really knows you, and it's sad, isn't it? Because it happens to a lot of people.
Now don't be too sad, because you can get a guy to like you without having to hide the real you. Just check out this video to learn 10 things you should do. Number 3, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. We know one way how to get a guy to like you is to show off that you're strong and independent.
You become this image of a strong and independent person because you want to be constantly focused on other people's problems rather than yours.
You use this as a mask to hide your problems and feelings. This is a habit for you, deflecting any focus away from yourself. You just don't want any attention to go to you because you don't want to go deep into who you are, right?
Everyone turns to you because you're the strong, real friend. But face it, deep down inside, you feel terribly alone and lonely. Want to know how to know if a guy likes you? It's simple. They strive to put focus on you, your thoughts, and problems. If he does this, then it means that he wants to know the real you, the vulnerable one, and not the strong one that everyone is used to. If all this is too real, I know, but we're cutting it for a while to remind you to stay tuned because at the end of this video, we'll tell you the number one way to cope with your fear of intimacy. It's going to be so valuable.
In the meantime, let's get to our last 2 items. Number 2, if you're happy and you know it.
Fear of intimacy, but you're positive and happy. You might be wondering how the two connect. It's going to make so much sense when we explain it.
You want to make a guy fall in love with you, so you show that you're a very positive and happy person. Because let's be honest, who doesn't like a person like that, right? You think that one way how to be more attractive is by spreading positivity around you. But if you become this jolly and positive person because you want to hide parts of yourself and avoid any deep connection, then you have a fear of intimacy.
The truth is, as humans, we only truly bond over our weaknesses and not our strengths. We only form long-lasting bonds if we see each other as vulnerable. When we share empathy and have a deep connection, this is exactly what someone with fear of intimacy is trying to avoid.
They're trying to avoid any hint of deep connection with anyone. That's why they show everyone that they're always happy and positive, like they have no problems and that they're not vulnerable at all.
However, you need to know that being vulnerable is one way to make someone fall in love with you because they see who you really are and accept you for that. Being vulnerable and more of that are the tricks to make any guy fall in love with you. To know more about it, just click on this video.
Number 1, give me love, give me affection. Someone who has a fear of intimacy would have a constant need of physical contact and affection. Hard to believe, right?
It is. I mean, it kind of doesn't make sense. Why would you want physical contact if you're scared of being intimate with anyone?
To be clear, a fear of intimacy can lead to extremes when it comes to physical contact. Of course, there are those who don't want any form of physical contact with anyone. But on the other side of the spectrum, a fear of intimacy can make you crave physical contact constantly. It can be because you want to pour all the attention into your physical contact and none of the attention to what's happening inside of you. Deep inside, people with this fear crave physical contact as a means to cope with the loneliness that they feel.
We're down to the last part of this video, which means that we're finally going to tell you the one way you can learn to stop being afraid of intimacy and how you can cope with it.
There are many ways to cope when you see the signs that you have a fear of intimacy. To be completely honest with you, it varies from one individual to another. However, there's a way that works for everyone. It's where anyone who has a fear of intimacy should start.
You should learn to accept and love yourself. It's the starting point for all intimacy issues anyone might have.
You have to learn to accept the things you've gone through, the things you're going through, who you were, who you are, and who you want to be. You have to accept every aspect of yourself, no matter how unflattering it may be. You're the first one who should love yourself unconditionally. You can never know the real answer to the question, "Is he into you?" if you don't love yourself. Just think of it this way. You can only learn to accept other people's affection if you can accept yourself.
Ladies, do you know any more signs of a fear of intimacy? Share it with us in the comments below and let's all be self-aware.
That's it, ladies. Once you're aware of the signs that you have a fear of intimacy, it's time to cope with that and stop having this fear of intimacy once and for all. And when you're through that, you should know all the things men want us to do more. This will help you become an even better person than you already are. Just check out this video where we tell you 15 things you should do more.